Jeanette and Rabia.
Welcome to Everest Physics Academy.
Before we start, we'd like to recommend our Everest Physics books for high school,
where you can find more explanations and solve applications and the problems.
In this video, we are going to explain why do sparks appear at the switch contacts when opening abruptly a circuit of large inductance. Connect a resistor and a diode between the terminals of the coil in order to avoid the damage of the switch. Connect a capacitor between the terminals of the coil in order to avoid the damage of the switch.
Sparks due to switching off a circuit of large inductance. In the shown experimental simulation, we have a battery, a lamp, an ammeter, a resistor, a coil of large inductance, and a switch. When this circuit carrying a current I, observe what will happen when we open the switch abruptly. Let's turn on the simulation. Now, a current is 69.2 mA in the circuit. When we open the switch abruptly, sparks appear at the switch contacts. Therefore, when a circuit of large inductance carrying an electric current is opened abruptly or suddenly, sparks appear at the switch contacts due to a very high voltage across its terminals originated from the high electromotive force induced in the coil. What happens when we open the switch, or why the induced electromotive force is very large in the coil? Answer: when the switch is opened suddenly, the current decreases to zero during a time delta T. In our experimental simulation, during the transient phase, the current decreases from 69.2 milliampere to zero. So during the transient phase, the current varies. So the magnetic field crossing the coil varies. Therefore, the coil is crossed by a variable self-flux. So it is the seat of a self-induced electromotive force.
The expression of the induced electromotive force is given from Faraday's law, E is equal to minus LdI by dt. But we want the average value of the electromotive force, which is E average. E average is equal to minus L delta I by delta t. But what is delta t? Delta t is the time needed by the current to decrease from its maximum value to zero when we open the switch. Delta t is equal to 5 tau. Tau is equal to L, the inductance of the coil, over the equivalent resistance of the circuit. Look at the figure. The equivalent resistance of the circuit is equal to the sum of the resistance R of the resistor and the internal resistance of the coil and the resistance R of the open switch. But the resistance R of the open switch is very large, so the equivalent resistance of the open circuit is very large. Now, if R circuit is very large, then delta T is very small. Consider this expression. If delta T is very small, then E average is very large. But if the induced electromotive force is very large, why do sparks appear at the switch contacts? Let's determine the expression of the voltage across the switch. We will apply Kirchhoff's voltage law and we will follow the positive sense. UFM, which is the voltage across the ideal battery, is equal to UFA plus UAB plus UBM. UFM is equal to E, the voltage across the ideal battery. UFA is the voltage across the switch, UK. UAB is the voltage across the coil. We follow the positive sense, so it is IR minus E. Similarly, the voltage across the resistor of resistance R is plus RI. Rearrange. UK is equal to E plus E plus a small e minus I into R plus R. But E is very large, so E is much greater than E and I into R plus R, which means that the voltage across the switch is much greater than E Then, sparks appear at the switch contacts due to electric discharge between its terminals during the decay of the current.
Avoiding the damage. We know that sparks damage the switch. To avoid this damaging, we introduce in this video two methods. First method, connecting a resistor and a diode between the terminals of the coil. But what is a diode and how does a diode work? The diode is an electrical component that allows the flow of current only in one direction, and it has two terminals, the positive terminal called the anode and the negative terminal called the cathode. To know how does a diode work, let's watch the two following simulations. In this simulation, the anode of the diode is connected to the negative pole of the battery, whereas its cathode is connected to the positive pole of the battery. Then the diode is reverse biased, and it acts as an open switch. Therefore, it does not allow the current to pass through it. As you see, the ammeter reads zero current. Now, in this simulation, the anode of the diode is connected to the positive pole of the battery, whereas its cathode is connected to the negative pole of the battery. Then the diode is forward biased, and it acts as a closed switch. Therefore, it allows the current to pass through it from the anode to the cathode. As you see, the ammeter reads 82.6 milliampere. So we can conclude that the diode allows the flow of current only when its anode is connected to the positive terminal of the battery and its cathode is connected to the negative terminal of the battery. Now, let's explain how does this circuit avoid the damage. When the circuit is closed, since the cathode of the diode is connected to the positive terminal of the battery, the diode is reverse biased and it acts as an open switch. Then it carries no current. So the current passes only in the circuit containing the battery, the switch, the coil, and the resistor of resistance R. Now, when the switch K is opening, the current passes in the coil from A to B, decreases to zero during the transient phase. So during this phase, the coil acts as a generator. And now, the anode of the diode is connected to the positive pole of this generator. So the diode in this case is forward biased, and a current passes in the closed circuit containing the coil, the diode, and the resistor of resistance R prime. Therefore, the magnetic energy stored in the coil is converted into thermal energy in the resistance of this circuit. Hence, no more sparks appear at the switch contacts.
Focus, please. This is important.
Observe this simulation. I will close the switch. So the current flows out from the positive pole of the battery. At this junction, we have two branches, the branch of the coil and the branch of the diode. But the diode is reverse biased, so it acts as an open switch, and the branch of the diode carries no electric current. So the current passes in the coil from left to right. Now the coil here acts as an electrical load or receiver, and it stores magnetic energy. Now I will open the switch. Observe. Pause. Now I pause the simulation. What happens when I open the switch? Now the coil will act as a generator and supplies its magnetic energy to the circuit. Here the current flows in the coil from left to right. At this junction, we have two branches, the branch of the open switch and the branch of the diode. The open switch has a very high resistance, so no current passes in the branch of the open switch, and the current passes in the branch of the diode, which is forward biased now, so it carries electric current, and the magnetic energy stored in the coil is transformed into thermal energy in the resistors of this branch. And in this case, we avoid the damage at the switch contacts because there is no current in the branch of the switch.
Now, we introduce another method to avoid the damage of the switch, and that by connecting a capacitor between the terminals of the switch. When the switch is opened, the electromagnetic energy stored in the coil and the capacitor decreases gradually, and it is converted into thermal energy in the resistance of the circuit while oscillating between the capacitor and the coil. This phenomenon is called the free damped electromagnetic oscillations, and it is studied in a video whose title is Electromagnetic Oscillations. Watch this simulation. A capacitor is connected in parallel across the switch. The current now has a value of 87.4 milliampere. When we open the switch, free damped electromagnetic oscillations take place and no sparks appear at the switch contacts. Thank you for watching. If you like this video,
subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and share.